Underground Railroad, the Underground Railroad. Everybody get on board.
Harriet Tubman, also known as Armonita Rouse, was born into slavery in 1822 in Dorchester County, Maryland. She was a well-known Underground Railroad conductor. At age 6, Armonita was old enough to be considered able to work. Edward Broadus, her master, lent her to a couple who first put her to work weaving, and she was frequently beaten by them. When she turned 11, she started wearing a bright condom bandana around her head, indicating she was no longer a child. She was also no longer known by her basket name, Armonita. Now she would be called Harriet after her mother. Harriet was always ready to stand up for others, especially someone from an angry overseer. The overseer threw Harriet 2-pound weight at the field hand, hitting Tubman on the head. Ever since then, she never fully recovered from this injury that haunted her the rest of her life. In 1844, at the age of 25, Harriet Tubman married a free black man named John Tubman. Since she was a slave, she knew that there would be a chance that she could be sold and her marriage would be split apart. Harriet dreamed of traveling north. There, she would be free and would not have to worry about having her marriage split up by the slave trade. But John threatened her that if she ran off, he would tell her master. Her goal to achieve freedom was too large for her to give up, though. So in 1849, worried that she and other slaves on the plantation were going to be sold, Tubman decided to run away. Her husband refused to go with her, so she set out with her two brothers and followed the North Star in the sky to guide her north to freedom. Her brothers became frightened and turned back, but she continued on and reached Philadelphia. There in Philadelphia, she found work as a household servant and saved her money so she could return to help others escape. The following year, with plenty of money at hand, she returned to Maryland to help escape her sister and her sister's two children to freedom using the Underground Railroad. Soon after, she returned to Maryland once again to free her brothers and two other men. Her third return, she went back for her husband to only find him already taken by another wife. Despite this, she saw other slaves seeking for freedom. Then after that, it became a habit of Tubman to return to the South again and again for about 10 years to free many more other slaves. She ended up freeing about 300 slaves. It has been said that she not once lost a single passenger. She would always carry a gun with her, which was used to threaten the slaves if they became too tired or decided they wanted to return back, telling them, "You'll be free or die." She didn't want to risk her other fugitives. Her dangerous work required tremendous risk. She usually worked during winter months to minimize the likelihood that she would be seen. In 1865, Tubman's capture was up to $40,000 reward from the South. For her major paviness, she became to be known as the Moses of her people. Frederick Douglass said, accepting John Brown of sacred memory, "I know of no one who has willingly encountered more perils and hardships to serve our enslaved people than Harriet Tubman." Becoming friends with the leading abolitionists of her era, Tubman took part in the anti-slavery meetings. Not only did she help many slaves into freedom, but she also worked for the Union as a cook, a nurse, and a spy during the Civil War. After the war, she settled in Auburn, New York, where she spent her life, later on dying there in 1913.